Well, I've been involved in three actions with the Biotic Bacon Brigade, one of which you heard my comrade talk about, pieing Robert Shapiro, which was awfully fun, and my first foray into the Biotic Bacon Brigade. Because I figured, hey, they didn't charge me. I'm still free to pie. So I went out on election night and had a little pie incident with Gavin Newsom, which, friend of the tenants everywhere. But that didn't get a lot of press either, and I was not arrested or charged, so I figured I'd keep going. Of course, my next incident, you probably all are a little bit familiar with, was the pieing of San Francisco Mayor Willie Brown. Yeah. And that was quite the event, because he was speaking at an event when he was pied. So not only did we have our Biotic Baking Brigade underground media there, the mainstream media was there and caught it all, and so it was broadcast on the news, which is really nice. Willie Brown getting pied broadcast internationally is just a great thing. But one of the things I want to do tonight is I want to make a little confession. I want to come clean about something. And what it is that after the pieing of Willie Brown, leading up to our trial, and even after our trial, we talked a lot about homeless issues. Two of the three of us who were charged in that case have been homeless activists for a long time, mostly with Food Not Bombs, but in other ways too. And Willie Brown's administration was proposing new ways of dealing with homelessness, which were essentially the same old ways. Push the homeless people out of sight, get them out of the tourist areas, send them off to the least populated places in the city, and if they won't go, charge them with stupid shit like drinking in public or, basically doing all the things that people who have houses do with impunity that you can't do in your house if you don't have a house. So we talked a lot about these things and sort of gave the impression, for legal reasons and other reasons, that that's why we pied Willie Brown. I did not pie Willie Brown to bring attention to homeless issues. I pied Willie Brown because I was following the prime directive of the Biotic Bacon Brigade, which is pie pompous people. And I don't know if you all can see this picture. You've probably seen it anyway. This is Willie Brown dressed up as a king with a crown and a cape. I mean, come on. Like, prime pie target. So the other thing that I was going to talk a little bit about was jail, because myself and my two co-defendants did go to jail for 4 months for pieing Willie Brown. And after our trial, which was kind of mundane, actually, not the circus you might have thought it would be, we were convicted of misdemeanor battery, which carries a maximum of 6 months in jail. And we knew that we were going to get the maximum, which is either 6 months in jail or 3 months probation. And when we got the probation sentencing report, they recommended that we get 3 years probation with a search clause, which means that anytime, anywhere, we could be searched, as well as anyone we were with, any car we were in, any house we were in. And we're all activists, we have friends who might or might not do things that they might or might not want the cops to know about. And so doing that would have meant we would have had to ostracize ourselves. And so, of course, we opted for jail. And having gone and spent that time there, it was clearly the right thing to do. If I hadn't done that, I would still be scared to, maybe even come to a place like this, because y'all could be searched if I was still on probation. AK Press's office could be searched or whatever. And having gone through that, I've encountered a lot of activists who will talk about jail as the worst thing that could happen to you. I can't go to jail. I'm needed on the outside. I can do a lot better work, on the outside. And I think that that's not the best way to look at jail, particularly considering that vast populations of people in the United States go to jail. When I was in jail, I saw people coming in, going out, coming in. There were several people who I saw 3 or 4 times come to jail. And that's reality for a lot of the communities in the country. Like, they or their families or the people they love are in and out of jail all the time. And so as people who want to change the world, one of the things that we need to do is activate or help to activate the people who are the most under the boot. And those are the people who are spending time in jail. And so being there really put me, gave me a lot of insight into what reality is like for the people who live on the streets, the people who have heavy-duty drug habits, the prostitutes, people who live a very, very different existence than probably most of us here in this space. It was a great learning experience, and I would, I think anybody who's faced with a situation where you have about a year or less in jail or heavy-duty probation, you should go to jail. It's not great. It kind of sucks, actually, but it's a little lonely, having to ask to go to the bathroom and things like that kind of suck when you're over five, but it's not the worst thing that can happen.